like this Squeezimals. We also have a Shopkins Happy Places, which are super cute, and a Shopkins Light Up. We also have a Poopsie, so let's get started. We're gonna start with Shopkins. So let's see who we have inside here. Oh, it looks like we have Cookie Cookie. I love Cookie Cookie. It is one of my favorite Shopkins, and it does have a little keychain. It also says, I love Shopkins, because I absolutely do love Shopkins. And it has a super fun light, so you can add this to your backpack or your keychain. Now we're gonna open up our Poopies, and I have never opened one of these before, so I have no idea what to expect other than poop and pee, which can be kinda gross. So let's just go ahead and tear right into it. It is not that easy to open, but I am hoping that these things are definitely not scented, because that would be very weird. And we have the plastic off, finally! So it looks like you have a checklist, and here's our toilet paper roll. It looks pretty realistic. That is so funny. So let's tear off this little paper, and it looks like I'm unrolling toilet paper, so I'm just gonna rip off a piece so we can get this poopy started. I mean, party started. Yeah, I meant party. Okay, so let's open our doors and find out what's inside. And it is a snowman. I thought it was gonna be poop or pee. It's a snowman. He's actually kinda cute. It's probably a pee snowman, but still super cute. So now on to our other door. Please don't be poop. Please don't be poop. I don't want poop. Okay, and it is Humpty Dumpty? I don't know. It doesn't look like a poop or pee. So this one actually is called Dutch Ovenness. So I'm guessing it's a fart. That's pretty clever. So let's put him back in there. Here is Dutch Ovenness and our pea snowman. I could not figure out that one's name. So it will be pea snowman. Now moving on to Happy Places, and this is the home decor one. And I absolutely love these for Barbie, also for LOL dolls. You can pretty much use these for all different types of dolls. So you get three blind bags and your tile, of course. So let's go ahead and rip this open and see what our first one's going to be. It looks like we have a little bottle. So, so cute and tiny. Now let's move on to our next bag. It doesn't feel like there's anything in here. Let's see if I can find it. Okay, here it is. It was so hard to find, but it's cute. It's a little sponge. Oh my goodness, so tiny. Now on to our last one. This one feels really big. And it is a little like bowl of bubbles. That is so cute. I don't know if it's like a dish, but it has a spot for your little sponge so you can actually like scrub stuff with it. Oh my goodness, that is so stinking cute. I love this. So, so cute. Okay guys, it's time for the grand finale. We're gonna open up our Squeezimal and see who we have inside. I am so, so excited about these. I hear they're super, super cute. They're supposed to be a squishy, yet a stuffed animal that's scented. So, so many cute things going on. Get out of this box, I wanna see you. And it is, aw, it's a little unicorn kitty. Super cute. Goes perfect with the channel name, Little Crafty Kitty. So yes, very, very cute. And I would love to make this my Blind Bag Tuesday little mascot. He can sit in some of the videos. So if you guys have any name ideas for him, let me know in the comments down below. Also, this is super soft and squishy, slow rising, and it is scented like a grape or sweet grape scent. Very, very cute. Highly, highly recommend these. So that is it for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed opening all these fun toys with me. Let me know in the comments down below which one was your favorite. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye! So you're probably wondering why you're watching Mind Back Tuesday on Wednesday. And it does have a story. And I don't want to confuse you by leaving this part out. So, it all happened yesterday when I went to go check on my pet hamster and pet mouse. They just got new cages, and I was super excited. But when I walked in, something terrible had happened. Panda, my hamster, escaped from her cage. She was running around the floor, and I knew this could be bad because my hamster and mouse didn't get along. But then I realized my mouse had passed. They must have gotten a fight, and I felt so bad. I blamed myself and Panda, my hamster. But then I realized I can't beat myself up. So I'm feeling a little bit better today, and I still have Panda. So things really could have been worse. But I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you very soon.